Allen's got a piece of, looks like one of those fasteners for his shin guards came off. Thought he was going to step on it there for a moment. Sean Pronger pushing and shoving Steve Moore. Steve hasn't had a shift for a while, so nobody's been after him. Todd Bertuzzi after Steve Moore. Grabs his shoulder, having a little chat with him, grabs his sweater, gives him a whack, and piling on is Andrei Nikolishin, and everybody's into it. Now we got a line brawl, and Hedberg wants Abisher. Johan Hedberg comes to center, and he invites Abisher, who points to the clock, and the score. Kurt Sauer being roughed up by Brad May. Oh, May just hit Kurt Sauer hard with a left hand.
Oh, Steve Moore's hurt really bad. Moore's head went into the ice.
And now they need a trainer on the ice in a hurry here. And the Vancouver trainer comes on quickly, and they need more than just the trainers. They're calling for medical help for Steve Moore. Steve Moore down in the pileup at center ice. An incensed Colorado bench. And the score settling has gone too far. Moore is moving his legs. It looked like he tried to get up, and they just told him to stay down here.
Yep.
We step out and take a break. 8-2, the Avalanche lead. Colorado Avalanche forward Steve Moore lies on the ice, getting lots of medical attention here, and will be carried off when they can stabilize things on the ice.
Yeah, the face of Steve Moore, his head goes down here. Bertuzzi goes after him, and he lands on him right there. And then the pile lands on Steve Moore. Looks like he's out at that point.
Another look at it. Bertuzzi wanted him. Piled on him, and you can see that his head hits the ice and everyone else piles on, and that doesn't help. And that's likely to cost Todd Bertuzzi. Fans in this building all standing,
yeah,
and quietly watching the scene.
At this point, you're just hoping that Steve Moore is all right.
Now, retribution was wanted for the hit on Marcus Naslund, but I can guarantee you that no one, not even Todd Bertuzzi, wanted this result.
Agreed. This has been a very weird game. This game has got out of hand in a number of ways.
It began with a record number of goals in a short order for the Colorado Avalanche, 4. In a minute and 39 seconds in the first period to open up a 5-0 lead. And at that point, Vancouver decided to start settling some old scores. There were some running at Moore. There were some hits on the top players. There were some challenging, the goading of the goaltender, David Abisher. And Marcus Naslund, who a couple of weeks ago was lying on the ice and had to be helped from it in Colorado, I'm sure has some concern here as he watches Steve Moore being attended to, all of these players do. We we step out again and hope for the best for Steve Moore. Former captain of the Harvard Crimson, Windsor, Ontario native Steve Moore of the Colorado Avalanche is being taken from the ice with lots of great medical attention around him, looking after him here. After an ugly incident at General Motors Place in Vancouver in an 8-2 game with the Colorado Avalanche leading. A game that meant so much for both teams in the standings that one wouldn't have predicted anything like this, but it got out of hand in the score early, so score settling started, and it's ended with this ugly incident and Todd Bertuzzi out of the game with a 5-minute penalty showing on the scoreboard. And I would think with 11 minutes and 19 seconds to go in the third period, that should put an end to the incidents.
Tony Granato just having a chat with Peter Worrell and others, just basically telling them that's it. Let's get this game done. I would agree with you, though, Jim. As much as this got aggressive as a game, there's nobody on that ice on either team that would ever have envisioned or wanted what happened to Steve Moore.
No, it just went a little too far. And there is a certain amount to be said for the way that some scores are settled in the NHL by the hard hitting against opponents' top players. You don't go to injure someone, you go after them, you go hard hitting. You make them understand that the top players aren't to be trifled with. And then it was Bertuzzi who wanted to settle a score for his linemate and good friend Marcus Naslund that went after Steve Moore. And he wanted to send him a message, but I don't think this is the message Bertuzzi wanted to send him.
Oh, great. So Johan Hedberg also received a minor for leaving the crease and coming to center ice. And it was Bertuzzi at the end of a shift that suckers Moore and then takes him straight down. And it was everybody piling on that may have hurt him just as bad.
Just made the situation worse, didn't it? Hedberg left his crease to try and entice David Abisher into a scrap. Abisher in an 8-2 game wisely said no thanks. And now there is a very subdued atmosphere everywhere in this building as this game between Colorado and Vancouver continues. And they can blow the horn and send everybody home, and I don't think anybody would now care.
Agreed. 11 minutes and 19 seconds to go in the third period.
Play will continue with the Avalanche on a 5-on-3. Their ninth power play of the game.